Like I stuck my head up out of the fog, and I all of a sudden I saw the good skaters. If you know what I mean.
I know what you mean, but yeah. What happened in Davos?
I don't know. I had 2 weeks with a lot of problems. I turned 30, and I felt a little
That's
bit.
That's a big problem.
It could be a crisis.
You
for
were
a couple
in
weeks.
Your midlife crisis?
Yeah, it could have been something like that. But I also had problems with my blades, and I got a little bit nervous, and I didn't know how to get out of the problem.
But let's talk about that crisis what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Every sportsman has that feeling. Are you asking yourself what you are doing in this world or what?
No, because I'm doing all right. I'm very happy, and I'm doing fine. Maybe, well, my girlfriend is far away in Canada, and of course sometimes that affects me too, but not to the extent that my skating deteriorates like it did last weekend.
But still, you're doing this for years and years and years and years.
Yeah.
Isn't it getting too much?
Sometimes it gets too much, you know. Sometimes I have a doubt whether I should go on or not. But then skating here in Heerenveen and skating good, like in the 500, then all of a sudden I feel I want to go on forever. Because it's...
But forever is a long time.
Yeah. Well, let's say at least 2 more years for Albertville.
You're still aiming for those medals?
Yeah, sometimes I am. But then at other times I think it's not fair to myself to talk about Albertville right now, because I have my bad moments too. Like last week, and I thought I would, well, I quit right now.
You were in a low.
Yeah. I was not on the European Championships team. It was Per Bengtsson. And I went here just to keep him company. And on Wednesday, you know, he went home, and I came back from Jan Bols. We fixed my skates, and
why Jan Bols?
The Kempkers broke me that last year, and I feel that I have a lot of confidence in him. In him.
In him. Just in him? I mean, other people can do your skates as well.
Yeah, but I like Jan. The way we talk and the way he thinks.
So
he really
more, it's more than just a technical thing.
Yeah.
Rounding your skates.
Yeah, yeah.
That's settled now?
I think so, because now I start skating again.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Can you please explain how it is possible that an athlete, 30 years old, breaks his personal record on the 500 by half a second?
I never skated inside before. And I always had problems with my 500, with the technique. But today I was eager. I wanted to skate good. I still had a lousy last outer turn, and
still you score a 38.10.
Yeah, because I felt something that I haven't felt for, well, let's say since Calgary. You know, the eager to really go for something.
But what is that? Pride?
Yeah, it's nice in front of all these people to really do well.
What is it? Can you explain that? I mean, we hear it.
Yeah.
But you live it.
Yeah, I live it. It's.
But how is that feeling? You go there as a Swede,
yeah.
Not as a Dutch guy, and you'll be cheered, and everybody is jubilant. What is that feeling?
No, it's when you cross the line and you see your time, you know, and also skating good, you know that you're doing good. Like when you actually do skate a personal record, you know when you cross the line that this is a good race, you know, and no matter if it's a good time or not, it triggers happiness, you know, and when you see the time, it's something extra.
Yeah, but
then the crowd comes, you know, and
it's like 12,000 people also know that's a personal.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's hard to explain. It's worth skating another year for.
What is it? Goosebumps? What kind of feeling does it give?
Not at that moment, but it's nice to think back of too, you know, like.
And it's worthwhile. Training for this, training so hard, like you did this summer?
No, I didn't train hard this summer.
Why not?
I didn't have the motivation to go on the same way as before. I thought I have to try something else. Like I ran a lot in the woods, orienteering, which is a beautiful sport, and it's actually my number one sport. That's what I've been talking about all summer. But and I found something else that I really, really like. Before it was just skating, and now I have something that sort of overrules the skating, takes the nervousness out of September and October, and I really enjoy training in a different way. But then next year, maybe I will have to do a lot more skating training again to get strong as I was before.
finishing this. You were written off last week. After the first day of this championship, you're the number 5, within reach.
Yeah, within reach of the best guys at the World Championships.
Not now, going in 3-4 weeks.
Yeah, we still have 2 races here, but I know that I see something else too.
You feel it as well?
Yeah, I do.
The real Gustafsson never gives up.
Yeah, because I haven't been able to race the way I have been wanting to, and now I feel that there is something of the old man coming back, and I like it.
Being 30, right?
Yeah, maybe. I'm gonna be 40 one day too. Then I will look like 30. Now I look like 20.
I hope for you.